things did you have to do as ambassador, and how did you engage the people when
okay.
you were ambassador?
What you have to do when you go as the ambassador is you represent your president and your country so that this country understands what we're about. So you're representing our rules, our laws, our philosophy. That's what you're representing. Normally you do that with other channels of government. I chose, because of who I am, to be with the people. And so I was saying, look at me, these are the things that we can do in my country now. Let's see if we can do these things here too. But we got to put them in the context of your country, you know. I was being asked, Embajador Jaramillo, what are you going to do about human rights in this country? And I'd say, I'll listen to what you're doing and I'll tell my president what you're doing about human rights, but you've got to initiate. I will tell you all the things that we do, but you know, so I kept saying you, and involving them. And then I started involving all the people, because I'd go out with the campesinos in the fields, and I'd go to all the churches, invite people to the house. Everybody was invited to the residence. It was, yes, the head of state and the congresspersons and the judges and all those people that have always been invited. But in addition, campesino groups, the unions, the taxi drivers, whoever, you know, they were invited to lots and lots of functions in the residence. So that was very different. And people got to know me as a person, you know. So what I was trying to do was to say, you know, here are two nations, yes, one is tiny and poor and one is big and powerful, but we've got the same needs for our people. We've got to be able to do this and this and this and this. And so just worked really, really hard at it. It was military dictatorship, and working on how we could become a democracy, and worked really, really hard. And there were wonderful leaders in the country already that just didn't have, had the opportunity to really move forward, and they moved forward. And I came home, and about 3 or 4 months later, they had their first elections. And you know, so that was really, really powerful. Another thing that I had been asked on my tasks to do was, there was trouble between Honduras and El Salvador with a boundary. And I was supposed to try to help with that. And we worked on that so nicely. Again, with not me taking any kind of visible kind of thing, but encouraging and encouraging and encouraging, and that got signed. Although today there's a little bit of trouble again, but look how many years later, you know, from 1978, I think, was when that was signed, or 79, so it's been a long time. So those are some of the big things, but what I'm most proud of is that I was able to bring in lots of the people without power, that they had a right to expect the basic things of life the way we do in this country, that they had to stand up and talk for themselves. And lots on the women, you know, because it was a time when that was being discussed here, so we were discussing it there. Really made good friends for our country. That was the thing. And personal friends to this day, you know, but it was just, but I worked really hard, set my own work standards, you know, the get to the office at 7 in the morning, and everybody was running around. The ambassador never goes to work until 10, right? So there I am early in the morning. If I didn't have a noon function, I would eat my sandwich at my desk. And, are you kidding? I was supposed to go play golf or something. I don't know. But just I'm a workaholic and I love to work and I had a job to do and so I really worked at it. And then go home around between 5, 5:30 and take a bath, put on high heels, change clothes and go off to a party every night. And that was where I did my best work. That's where the ambassador works. You meet all the diplomats from all over the world. You meet the people that are making the decisions. So you work very hard till 12, 1 o'clock in the morning, and by 7 next morning you're back at work. It was very hard work, but I loved it. I loved every minute of it. It was just wonderful.
So now...